Hello, my name is Evan. This is my YouTube channel. Say hello to Evan.
Hello.
What's up, folks? Thanks for tuning in. It's Sunday, which means once a week on Sunday, my plan is that I'm going to do a video that's a little longer. And after I play my song, maybe talk more in depth about the song, which I've been doing anyway during the week, but trying to make those videos short. But even more than that, try to talk about what's going on with me personally and what's going on in the world. So I'm going to do that today. And the song that I'm going to play, if you've seen my videos, of which there are like 30, there's a lot of videos. And in a lot of them, I talk about this creative burst that I had a few weeks ago. But it's actually like 2 months ago now. And I've played some of the songs, like 5 or 6 songs came out of me in a week. And I say came out of me, I talk about that, like I feel like I just plucked them or I'm channeling them or whatever. Yes, I wrote them, but it just feels like they just come. And I feel blessed and fortunate and grateful that I have that gift / ability or whatever you want to call it. It feels like a gift. So this is one of the songs, it's called Rain. And it goes like this, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Never thought that I would ever make it to the other side. Fist clenched so tight I just couldn't let go. So, thank you for letting me play that. So that song, right? The melodies, you know, they just come, and then words start coming, and the rain came. It just seemed so obvious that that was the chorus. Then the rain came falling, and the rain came falling down. And those words meant a lot to me when I put them down on the paper. 2 months ago, a month ago, whenever it was. And that was my experience with my life. Already I had had that experience where I couldn't let go of things, my behaviors, my actions, and you know, all the stuff. I'm in recovery from alcoholism, and it took a long time for me to get to a place where I could deal with all that stuff. And so these words, they already meant a lot to me. Today, they mean, since from then to today, they mean even more. What's been happening for me over the past few weeks is this. So it's just crazy. Sometimes, and that happens a lot with me, where when I write songs, sometimes there's words down there and I'm like, I think they mean one thing, or I don't know what they mean. And then years later, I'm like, something happens, or it comes and I'm like, oh, well, now I see what that was. It's weird. It's awesome, actually. And I like the idea that songs can evolve, the meaning of songs can evolve, it doesn't have to have one meaning. Just for me personally, never mind for everybody, right? So, you thought I was done talking about Katie Rubin, but I'm not, because I watched her show last night. I streamed her show and it was awesome. And she is someone who has helped me to pull the lever to open my mind wide. You know, just the way that she talks about her experience with racism and white privilege and white fragility. That's a book that she suggested that I got it and I'm listening to it right now. And it's white fragility. It's why it's so hard to talk to white people about racism. And she's laying it out brilliantly. And the author is, and so is Katie. It just makes a lot of sense to me the way she talks about it. And you know, I've just all these years, and I talked about it, I think, in another video. This is my silence. It's silent complicity is what it is. I've been complicit the whole time that I've been silent. That I've said, oh well, I'm not a racist, so that's it. That's not it. And I'm familiar with the history of black folks in America and their treatment and stuff like that. But if I was really familiar with it, then I would be fucking outraged, like I am now. You know, I watched 13th just before her show last night. It's on Netflix. It's a documentary, which she had mentioned also. And she talked about that last night too. And I mean, it's just insane. It's such a blatant structure that this country is built on, and the criminal justice system especially. But the whole thing is we're all conditioned, and we're all conditioned, everybody is conditioned, that white people are better than and have more value than black people especially, but people of color in general. I'm going to talk about the black experience. Excuse me, I probably shouldn't say that. That's certainly, you know, I'm trying to empathize. I can't put myself in their shoes. There's no fucking way. No, I can't really, but I'm trying to, I can understand as much as I can as a white person why they're so angry. And the whole criminal justice system needs to be overhauled. It's totally screwed. It's insane. Just watch 13th if you haven't watched it, and maybe you'll be like, oh, whatever, that's fine. But please, just try to, just watch it. It's hard to watch that and not see how horrible. People think that racism ended in 1865 when slavery was over. 1863, 1865. But definitely then in 1964 when they passed the Civil Rights Act, right? No. It's all there. It's the foundation of the system. So what I've decided is that, because I got really angry. And the problem with us white folks is that when we do come to and realize, oh my God, I have been complicit in this. And yes, of course, I'm conditioned white privilege, of course. And then we get, we feel guilty and shame, and got to get right past that. Forget about that. That's a pity party. That's self-pity. Think about what black folks have had to deal with, okay? Us realizing that we haven't done enough than we should is nothing, okay? We have to get past that so that we can go from here and move forward. What can we do now, okay? We have to get educated. I'm trying to educate myself. I'm listening to this book. I watched the documentary. There's a whole lot of stuff. There's a lot of people who talk that I need to listen to. And white people, I need to start talking to people who don't have the same opinion as me, because me talking to them, that's great and all, and that, yeah, it confirms, yeah, right. See, we're right, right? Yeah, this is the right way. I need to start talking to people who don't think the way that I do. And I need to not just argue with them and say no, and try to explain to them why they're wrong and why I'm right, just like they try to do with me. That's not gonna help anything. We need to look at what the root is. Why do you feel that way? Why do I feel this way? And it's all, you know, it's all around societal racism and white privilege and white fragility, not wanting to talk about it. Not only being afraid, but getting defensive. Racism, how dare you say I'm racist? I was raised in my family, and we were colorblind. We looked at people as everyone's equal. That's great if you think that, and if you looked at everybody as being equal, but they weren't. That's not their experience. And not only does it not matter that your family raised you in a way to not be racist, it doesn't matter. We're conditioned. Society conditions us for us to believe that as white people, we have more value than black people. And that's it. I mean, so it's hard to not get angry, right? This is the test. Because I have to come from a place of love. I keep talking about love is love, and I want to bring people together, and unity and empathy and all these things. Well, I need to try and empathize with people who have a different opinion than me and try and figure out why it is that they feel that way, and let them talk about that and let me listen. I listened to my friend last night, and he helped me to realize, because I was so angry, that I wanted to, you know, it's like to jump into this war that's happening, this revolution that's happening. But for me to do that before I actually come from a place of love and try to give another person a platform and let them speak, and then let's look at why they feel that way, and let's look at why I feel that way. And if I can't do it and I can't get through, then that's fine. But I have to try. I feel like I have to try. For me to just jump into the war is me jumping on the bandwagon, is what it feels like, and trying to make up for all that lost time. And that's not what I'm gonna do. I'm trying not to do that. The other thing is, I can say as much as I want, but until I do something, it doesn't matter. Our actions speak louder than words. Yes, absolutely. I can talk up a storm and then fucking go sit down and you know, and watch Deadwood again. Deadwood's so awesome. Right? I gotta do stuff. I gotta try and talk to people. So I'm gonna try to do that. And I could go on and on. I want to thank Katie Rubin again, and you should please support her however you can. She's an important voice, especially for white women out there. And I've had great support from my family and my friends. And I'm gonna stop now. I feel good about the way that song came out. Of course, I feel like the talking part isn't. People that are smarter than me and better speakers than I am say it way better than I do. I'm just trying to share the way that I feel and about what's going on in this world and what I think that I can do about it, or that I should do about it. So please comment, make comments in the comment section. And if you feel differently, then let's talk about it. Seriously. And again, you know, go in the comment section, make requests, say whatever, say, yeah, that, thank you, Evan, for that. And, or, you know, Evan, I don't know, dude, I'm not sure that you're seeing this. And I'll say, okay, tell me another way. I've said this about last Sunday, about keeping an open mind. And I kept an open mind last night. I'm going on more now, right? I kept an open mind last night in the conversation with my friend where it started as like, oh, what? No, you can't. And anger and frustration. And I was able to listen to him, and it made sense. So, all right, I hate when people do this, and I'm doing it right now. So please make a comment, make a request. If you haven't liked the videos, if you watch them and you like them, please press the like button. And if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. I'm gonna go now. Love is love. Take care, everyone. Please take care of each other. This will shut off now.